Here, everybody, with a very pleasant morning and with very happy faces. I welcome you all. And it has been said by such a wonderful philosopher that today is the day. That's why it's called present. Today is a gift from God. That's why it's called present. So I think the God has gifted us with a beautiful morning, with the company of a beautiful, people with beautiful smiles. So I welcome you all with the core of my heart. Welcome here. So the conference started at on 6th of this month, 6th of May, and we enjoyed. Wonderful speakers on that very day in different plenary sessions, and the technical sessions were also there, and the chairpersons were amazing. They chaired the session beautifully, and equally wonderful were the presenters who presented their papers on diverse topics and opened our mind with various thoughts, and it was a wonderful experience, I must say. And I know that you all will do agree with what I am saying. And then on the second day tomorrow, we again had a wonderful experience with some learned personalities all over the world, and they were just phenomenal. And there were again various areas of the literature and the teaching, learning, and education. The various aspects were covered by the presenters, and the chairpersons were equally very important and very cherishing there. And it was a wonderful experience, and I think that today we are going to have the same experience and even more than that. So let's begin this third day international, third day of the 3-day international virtual conference on teaching, learning, and education, jointly organized by Government College of Education, Canal Road, Jammu, India, State Islamic Institute, Madurai, Indonesia, Universitas Muhammadiyah Sidenag, Arapan, Indonesia, Universitas at Asharia, Mandar, Indonesia, Cape Comorin Trust, India, Lavender Literary Club, India, in association with Cape Comorin Publisher, India. So I welcome you all on this wonderful occasion. And one more thing I want to tell you that, and rather I would like to congratulate the Cape Comorin Publisher for the new book that they have, for their new book on war, pandemic, and humanities, volume 3, and it has been jointly edited by Kumar Abhimanyu Dev Bilavaria sir and Dr. Shubhra Jamwal. I congratulate to you both, and especially to Regin sir. Congratulations to everyone, and congratulations to the editorial team of the Cape Comorin Publisher also. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So shall we begin with the next speaker, ma'am, with your permission?
Yes, I think so has joined us.
Now is the time to call upon the screen, the resource person and the speaker for the plenary session number 11 of this, the third day of the 3-day international virtual conference on teaching, learning, and education. Yes, I'm talking about Dr. Umar Bukhari, sir, senior lecturer, State Islamic Institute, Madurai, Indonesia. Umar Bukhari, sir, is a doctor of Arabic language teaching at State Islamic Institute of Madurai, Indonesia, as a senior lecturer Welcome, sir. Welcome here. Yeah, who teaches in Faculty of Education for about 12 years and Faculty of the Waqf for about 5 years in the material related with Arabic language and Islamic philosophy. He joined doctoral program at postgraduate of Sunan Kalinganaga State Islamic University, Yogyakarta, in Islamic Studies and graduated at 2018. He has been called by as a resource person for various events, seminars, webinars, and conferences. He has presented many papers in various conferences and seminars, and they also have been published in various journals internationally and nationally. He has conducted several researches about Arabic language teaching, translated several Arabic books into Indonesian language, and became the board of many social organizations in Madura Island. So with these words, may I please welcome Dr. Umar Bukhari, sir. Most welcome, sir, and over to you, sir. Sir, please unmute yourself. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for all participants or and audiences of this seminar titled on teaching, learning, and education. But before beginning of my presentation, I would like to say that I am sorry to all of Indian society for increasing the COVID-19 sufferer lately. I am sorry for this. May our Lord save us from the increasing more and more in COVID suffering. Okay, firstly, I would like to share my screen. First, I would like to present my paper on entitled The Method of Learning Sacred Text in Islamic Boarding School or in Pesantren, Case Study at Madura Island in Indonesia. Madura Island here is located in the east of Java Island in Indonesia. Okay, I begin with my research background. My research background show that actually in Indonesia tradition, Islamic boarding school, or we call in Indonesian term is pesantren, known as the oldest traditional Islamic institution in Indonesia. There are we all read the data on in the religious ministry, there are more than 1,000 Islamic boarding school all over in Indonesia. The characteristic of Islamic boarding school or pesantren contain the indigenousity and the accommodation of local wisdom, and also the principle of sincerity, the principle of simplicity, etc. But all of us know that one of the most important principle applied inside Islamic boarding school or in pesantren is preserving the good old and adopting the best new, or we can call, or if I translate into its original term in Arabic, al-muhafadha al-qadim al-salih wal-akhdhu bil-jadid al-aslam. But the most problem I find in pesantren's context of problem, that most material of Islamic studies inside pesantren, especially in Madura Island, are learned by the student or by the santri as the sacred text. This is I think the specific problem of this research, because of its close relationship with the santri's religiosity or the santri's Islamic experiences. Daily, all of students in Islamic boarding school or in pesantren, of course, doing what their call Islamic experiences. The santris all doing what the Islamic teaching every day in every activity. So if when all of the student learn about material of Islamic studies inside the pesantren, so all of them assume that all of the material are the sacred text because it's close relationship. So based on the research background above, I ask the research question contained. First question, how was the student learns the material of Islamic studies inside several Islamic boarding school in Madura Island, East Java of Indonesia, and how does the method of learning applied in their daily activity? I conducted the research. This research begin from 2040 of ED. This is in pre-research process and conducted in all of this research begin from 2016 until 2017. It is located at three Islamic boarding school at Madura Island, within among more than 800 Islamic boarding school. So in Madura Island here, when I have seen at statistical data, there are more than 800 pesantren all over Madura Island. And the technique of data collection, I use participatory observation, depth interview and documentation, and triangulation of source and method used as the technique of checking data validation. Okay, based on the research, based on the research method above, I find many research finding. The first is most of santri or most of student of Islamic boarding school consider that all Islamic lesson they have learned are containing the sacred material, because as I see more and more, because all of the Islamic material has close relationship with their religiosity understanding. And secondly, most of the Islamic lesson contain the materials written in classical book, heritage book, or we call in Indonesian term kitab kuning, which including different Islamic studies. So the material inside the classical book not only related with Quranic studies as the holy book of Muslim, but it's also contain the tafsir or Quranic exegesis, the hadith or prophetic tradition, Islamic jurisprudence, Arabic grammar. So the sacred aspect of the material is not only because the content related only with the holy book, only with the Quran. And the third research finding that there are three different prime goals of learning the materials. Firstly, the student always memorize the material. This is the prime goal of learning the material. And the second, the student would like to understand the material. And the third, the student would like to memorize and understanding the material at the same time. At the first time, they would like only to memorize. The second, they would like to understand the material. And the third, they would like to memorize and understanding the material at the same time. And so I would like to conduct the discussion in three aspects. First aspect is the sacrality aspect of the text. The second is how the student use the method of learning the sacred text. And the third is the application of that method. The sacrality aspect of the text, I can see here based on my analysis to the research finding that all texts learned by students are containing the sacred dimension. Of course, first because of its content. So the content of Islamic material contain the sacred aspect, especially Quranic studies or prophetic tradition, etc. And also, the material contains the spiritual gnostic effect for the student. So when the student try day by day, time by time to learn all of the material, they find spiritual effect in their self. They see that in Arabic terminology, they find khudu and khushu. Khushu here, I cannot find the translation into English terminology. But the third aspect here, there are the ritual dimensions. So when the student learn about Islamic material inside Islamic boarding school, inside the pesantren, the student find that all of them feel the its ritual more good day by day. And so there are many other dimensions. And the second sacrality aspect of the text, that the sacred dimension of the text met the different specific attitudes among the student, among the readers of the text, especially related with how they respect the teacher guidance. And I would like to explain the second sacrality aspect of the text here in next slide. Okay, next slide. The method of learning the sacred text, there are three methods used by the student to learn the materials of Islamic studies inside pesantren. Firstly, learning through the teacher. I think this is the most important one of how the student learn the sacred text inside the pesantren. And the second method is the strategy of i'lan. I'lan here is Arabic terminology, and if I use the free translation into English, is i'lan here is similar with open demonstration. And the third method is autodidact. All of students must use this one, learning himself the materials without the teacher's guidance. Okay, next slide. All of the students apply the method or the three methods as I explained above, that the student use two techniques. Contain the first, the i'lan or the open demonstration, because I can see the open demonstration here because the student must register himself to the teacher, maybe the teacher of pesantren, to show what he have learned in front of all of the student, and also in front of their parent, when the parent invited into the pesantren to look at or to see how their son can show the result of learning, of course with understanding the materials or not. understand the material or not here is based on the goal of learning. As I have explained before, that the learning of sacred text, the goal is not only to understand the material, but of course in the other goal is to only to memorize the material. Okay, and then the second method is the studies with understanding the material. The student study about Islamic material just only to conduct the goal of understanding. Both of technique have different characteristic. The first technique in the Iqlan is I have the underline based on the teacher guidance. So because the text is sacral, has this as sacrality aspect, so the student must learn the material by the teacher guidance. This is the first. The secondly, the application of the method depend entirely on the text. So the student did not permit to have attitude independent from the text, because because the goal of at least the goal of learning is only to memorize the text. Whether afterward the student memorize and understanding at the same time, or only memorize. But the second technique is also based on the teacher guidance. This is I have underlined for all student inside pesantren. He must learn all of Islamic material by teacher guidance, because the text has a prime sacrality aspect. But in the second technique here, the prime goal is only to understand material. But if there are the other goal of the student to combine between memorizing and understanding at the same time, so afterward the student must consult with the teacher. But this is I say you again that I have underlined this one. The student must consult the teacher for find the teacher guidance, because of the close relationship that the material here has a prime sacred text. Okay, I think enough for my presentation. Thank you for all participants and audiences, and I am sorry for the problem of internet. Thank you very much. Hello.
Thank you so much, Dr. Umar Kari, sir, for such a detailed and such a wonderful lecture. It was a pleasure listening to your wonderful lecture. Wonderful. Now I'll the house is open for question answer round. So the audience have any questions, they can ask. So the house is open to the audience for the question answers.
Tak gede. Orang yang saya cakap tak gede.
Questions from the audience side?
Question.
I can hear the voice. Problem of internet again. Problem of networking again.
You are audible, sir. Your voice is coming perfectly good.
Okay, I'm sorry, this a problem of networking and internet again. Sorry, I cannot hear something about the question.
So anybody who has a question for Dr. Omar, so they can ask. You can also use the chat box for asking your questions. So, no questions, I guess.
Okay, because I think my materials are very string.
Actually, sir, it indicates that how beautifully you have, you know, made us understand everything that you said, that it has, left no void and no trace of doubt and error in their mind, and even questions also. So
because the case only in Madures Island, and especially only in the Indonesian country.
Thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful
presentation. You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So with this, we are done with our plenary session number 11 with Dr. Omar Bakhari, sir, from Indonesia. Thank you so much, sir.